श्रीमान वेंकटनाथार्य कवितार के केसरी वेदांताचार्यवर्यो में सन्निधत्तां सदा हृदि नमो नारायण। दस ही परफॉर्म्ड प्रपत्ति एंड हयग्रीवन वितिस हेशो दोषम वितिस घोषम वितिस हेशा हलहलह वितिस साउंड neighing sound, the horse. He saw kala hala hala. Here, hala hala sounds is the one that comes out of Lord, protects us by having no vignam to this jnanam. So, may of the horse sound, kata tarpa kshupya katakakula khola hala bhavam. Here, kata darpa kshubhya kataka kula hola hala sounds are in the form of the tree of Samavedam, Saman, with its thousand branches. And that's what is talked about here. So, kata darpa kshubhya kataka kula hola hala bhavam. Very nicely, Swami Desikan mentions, and because of the power of this hala hala sound, which will chase away the inner darkness of those who get disillusioned, as well as by the loud and confusing sound or the arguments of the non-Vedic and the Avedic, and those who distort Vedic truths and talk something else of the arrogant with their own pride and viparita jnana, the other siddhantis, and they get chased away. They themselves get chased away, or the people who get misled, their ignorance and darkness get chased away with this halahala sound. Swami, hence, this is an appropriate slokam for Swami Desika to choose as the Mangala slokam of Satadushani. Satadushani is a beautiful notes which he has taken when he was establishing the unambiguous Vishishtadvaita Sri Vaishnava Sampradayam, Siddhantam, in front of an Advaitin. And he establishes this Satadushani's work, where the Mangala Slokam is this Slokam. Samahara Samnam Pratipadamajam Dhamayajusham Layapratyuhanam Laharvedir Bodhajaladehe Katadar Pakshubhya Katakakula Kola Halabhavam Haradvantar Dvantam Hayavadana Hesha Halahalaha. And may the neighing sound generated by Lord Hayagrivan, who possesses a beautiful, divine, majestic, illustrious face, that of the horse, remove, dispel completely the inner darkness of people. May it help me that way, that neighing inhalation sound generated by Hayagrivan, which is truly the sum total, the aggregate of Samaveda mantras, which is truly synonymous with Rig mantras word for word, and which is the very seat, residence of Yajurveda as well as the Atharvana Veda. So, which is itself the exactly equivalent of removal, destruction of all obstacles, hurdles in our spiritual enhancement, in our spiritual path, and which is the array of waves in the ocean of our spiritual realization. And this will negate our viparita jnana, our illusions, our disillusionment, our getting misled, confused by listening in from the experience of debates in which the proud or the falsely proud, arrogant debaters assail with great noise, with the bombastic jargons, with beautiful words, without reason, without rationale, without any concrete pramanams, by some logic, and who merely depend on the loudness of their queries, born out of mischievous doubt, they establish their avaidika truths, distorted truths, and thereby confuse us. That this halahala sound will negate that viparita jnana. And as quoted earlier, the neighing of the and the breath of the Lord is Veda coming out. Because the first we talked about the Hayagriva Stotram, that Veda is nothing but the breath of Perumal. So this halahala sound is nothing but the Veda. So the detail is given in this verse that Hayagriva Mantram itself in sound form is like the breathing or neighing, the Ekakshara Mantram. And as spelt out, this reference is to the Ekakshari spelt out in Upanishad, which Swami very nicely says that this Sunadams associated with Sri Hayagrivans are the integrated essence of three Vedams. So here he says the Laya Pratyuhana Laharvidatir Bodha Jalatehe. Pratyuhana Layaha Bodha Jalatehe Laharvidati. That's the order. And Pratyuha means impediment, obstacle, hindrance. These obstacles relate to the acquisition of the right jnana. The halahala dvani of Hayagrivan destroys those hurdles, interruptions, impediments, and thereby we will get the right jnana. The pratyuhanam, ham pratyuham, reach the state of hayavadana, reach the state of layam. Hayavadana hesha halahalaha pratyuhana layaha. That's what Swami Desikan reveals to us as the vaibhavam of Hayagrivan. Hesha halahalaha is being described here. That neighing sound echoing continuously and creating sarva mangalam are the never ceasing ocean waves. Laharivitati. It's a ocean of waves. The waves from the ocean of jnana, bodha jaladehe. So laharivitati is the never ceasing waves which come from the ocean of jnanam, which is bodha jaladehe. These waves completely immerse us in the nectar of Divya Jnana and wonderful right Jnana. About the Jnanam of Jivatma, about Achetana, about Hayagrivan, as together bonded with each other, with the Sarira Sariri Bhava, the Vishishtadvaita Sri Vaishnava Sri Sampradaya Siddhanta. These are the bhaktas of Sri Hayagrivan who receive such anugraham. The halahala dhvanis have the power of removal of inauspiciousness, removal of vignams. And these waves from Lord Hayagrivans are jnanananda mayalahari, embodiments of the waves of jnanam and bliss combined. So, and the third and fourth is Katadar Pakshupya Katakakola Kola Halabhavam Haradvantar Dvantam Hayavadana Hesha Halahala. Here, Sri D. Ramaswami Iyengar, the Paramapadavasi, mentions that the prayer voiced in this slokam is that our inner darkness get dispelled, removed by this halahala sound. And the cause for the avidya, the inner darkness, the confusion settling in our mind is because of those others who with arrogantly, noisily propounding the superiority of the various systems of thought rooted in avaidika and kutrushti madam. So the sounds of Hayagrivan alone can dispel the confusion caused by their uproar of their kolahalam of disputants. So that's what is talked about here. Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya Hayavadana Hesha Halahalaha will remove the darkness and take us to the light. Kavitarkika Simmaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha Namo Narayana Adiyen.